In this video, we are going to discuss about types of function arguments in Python programming. So mainly we have four types of function arguments are there. In this video, we will discuss about those four arguments. The first type of function argument is required arguments. Required arguments, or which can also be called as positional arguments. So other name for required arguments is positional arguments. The second type of argument is keyword arguments. Third one is default arguments. Fourth one is variable length arguments. Variable length arguments, which can also be called as arbitrary arguments. So these are the four types of arguments that we have in functions. So first let's see about the first one. The first one is required argument or positional argument. We know that arguments can also be called as parameters also. So the first one is required parameter or positional parameter. In this, we have to follow two points. The first one is the number of arguments must be same in function definition and function declaration. Suppose if function definition contains two arguments, then function declaration should also contain two arguments. Suppose if the function definition contains three arguments, then function declaration should also contain three arguments. So that is the first point here. So number of arguments must be same in both function declaration and function definition. And the second point is position. Here position can also be called as order. So position or order is important here. Position or order is important here. So that means we have to follow the position or order. Let's take an example here. Let us define a function here. So def, let name of the function is subtraction. So def sub of a comma b comma c. Here let us display the result. So print of, let us do the subtraction on abc. So print of a minus b minus c. Next let us call the function. Let the first function call is like this: sub of 10 comma 20 comma 30. Second function call: sub of 20 comma 30 comma 10. Third function call: sub of 30 comma 20 comma 10. Now let's see how it can be executed. So here the first function call is sub of 10 comma 20 comma 30. So here we are using which one? Required arguments or positional arguments. Required arguments means the number of arguments must be same in function definition and function call. Here the function definition contains three arguments. The function call also contains three arguments. So there is no problem here. And what is the second point? It follows the position or order. Here what are the parameters here? 10, 20, 30. So whenever this function is called, then 10 will be passed to A, 20 will be passed to B, next 30 will be passed to C. Print of A minus B minus C. So in comments I am writing the output. So 10 minus 20 means minus 10, minus 10 minus 30 means minus 40. So we will get minus 40 as the output. So once it is over, once the function definition execution is over, control comes to the next statement after the function call. So this is the next statement. So here also the number of arguments are 3. So there is no problem. And what is the order here? 20, 30, 10. So 20 will be passed to A. So this is nothing but positional argument. In which order we passes the arguments? In those order only the corresponding values will be stored in the corresponding arguments. Okay. So 20 will be stored here. Next, what is the second parameter? 30. So 30 will be stored in B. Next, what is the third parameter? 10. So 10 will be stored in C. Why? Because here we pass this in 20, 30, 10 order. So 20 means A value, 30 means B value, 10 means C value. Now what is the output? 20 minus 30 means minus 10. Minus 10 minus 10 means minus 20. So we get minus 20 as the output. If you take the third function call, then 30 will be passed to A. Next, 20 will be passed to B. And then 10 will be passed here. So 30 minus 20 means 10. So 10 minus 10 means 0. So we will get 0 as the output. Okay. Let us assume that here I called one more function. So sub of 30 comma 20. Then we will get an error message. Python interpreter will displace error message. Why? Because here the number of arguments are 3. Whereas here we passes only 2 arguments. So that's why we will get an error message. Okay. Here these arguments are called as what? Actual arguments. The parameters of calling function are called as actual arguments. Whereas A, B, C, these arguments are called as formal arguments. Formal arguments means function definition arguments, called function arguments. Whereas actual arguments means function call parameters. Okay. So if we call a function like this, then we will get error message. Okay. Why? Because here number of arguments are 3. Whereas here the number of arguments are 2. So that's why we'll get the error. Okay. We can overcome this problem with the help of the second approach. The second approach is keyword arguments. Here also the number of arguments must be same in function definition and function call. If function definition contains 2 arguments, then function call should also contain 2 arguments. Otherwise we will get an error message. And what is the second point here? In required arguments, position or order is important. So that means we will follow the order. Whereas coming to the keyword arguments, here order is not important. Order is not important. We should not follow any order here. Here we will provide values to the arguments with the help of a keyword. So we will assign values based upon the keyword. Here keyword is nothing but name of the argument. Okay. Let's take an example here, so that we can get the perfect clarity. Same function definition. Let us call the function sub of A is equal to 10 comma, B is equal to 20 comma, C is equal to 30. Second function call sub of C is equal to 30 comma, A is equal to 10 comma, B is equal to 20. Third function call sub of B is equal to 20 comma, A is equal to 10 comma, C is equal to 30. So here in the function call, what we are doing, we are assigning values to the corresponding names here. Here these variable names are called as keywords here. Here we will perform the initialization based upon the keyword. Keyword is nothing but what? Variable name. Keyword is nothing but variable name. So whenever we will call a function like this, then what will happen is, what is A value now? 10. So 10 will be stored in A here. So here what is A? Here we have A. So 10 will be stored in A. Next to B is equal to 20. So 20 will be stored in B now. C is equal to 30. So 30 will be stored in C now. So what is the result? 10 minus 20 means minus 10. Minus 10 minus 30 means minus 40. Let's see the next function call. Sub of what is C value? C value is 30 only. So this 30 will be stored in this A, this C. Next, what is A value? 10. So this 10 will be stored here. What is B value? 20. So this 20 will be stored here. So we are getting the same output, minus 40. Next, if you observe the last function call also, B is equal to 20. So 20 will be stored here. A is equal to 10. So 10 will be stored in A. C is equal to 30. So 30 will be stored in C. So here also we will get the same output. Okay. So this is about keyword parameters. Keyword parameter means we use the keywords. We use the names. So here the order is not important. Only that name is important. So in every function call, the values are same only. A value 10, B value 20, C value is 30. So we will get the same output in all the cases. So here we can say that order or position is not important here. We should not follow order or position. Here we performed the initialization based upon the keyword, based upon the variable name. So based on that only, just the values will be passed. Okay. So this is about keyword arguments. Now let's see the third one, that is default arguments. So what is the use of default arguments? Let the function definition contains four arguments. Let the function definition contains four arguments. Then till now the function call should also contains four arguments. But we can call the function with four arguments, three arguments, two arguments, one argument or zero argument also with the help of the default values. So default arguments are mainly useful when we want to call a function with less number of arguments. Okay, let's take an example here so that we can get the perfect clarity. Let we have definition function def sum of. Here in function definition we have to perform the default value initialization. So let we have four variables here: a comma, b comma, c comma, d. Okay, a comma, b comma, c comma, d. Here we can perform the initialization only from right to left. So from in this order only we have to perform the initialization. So let d value is some 40, c value is 30, b value is 20. So likewise we can perform the initialization. So let us assume that there is no default value for a. So that if we call the function with less number of arguments, then these default values will be used now. So let's see the code here. So return, here we are performing addition operation. So return a plus b plus c plus d. Okay, let us call the function now. Before that, let us declare some parameters. A is equal to 1, b is equal to 2, c is equal to 3, d is equal to 4. Let the first function is like this, sum of 1. Second function call, sum of 1 comma 2. Third function call, sum of 2 comma 3 comma 4. Last function call, sum of 1 comma 2 comma 3 comma 4. Now let's see how it will be executed. So sum of 1, so this is the function call. So here we are supplying only one argument, but the function definition contains how many arguments? Four arguments. So in that occasion what will happen is this 1 will be stored in the first argument. So now a value will become what? 1. Okay, here we have only one argument, so this 1 will be passed to the a. So the remaining variables values are nothing but default values. So these default values will be taken by the Python interpreter. So b value 20, c value 30, d value 40. So what is the sum now? So 40 plus 30 70, 70 plus 20 90, so 90 plus 1 91. So we will get 91 as the output. Next, sum of 1 comma 2. So here we are passing two values here. So these two values will be stored in the first two parameters. So now a value will become 1, b value will become 2. So the remaining two variables values will become, the remaining two arguments values will become 30, 40. So those values, those default values will be taken now. So 40, 30, 70, 70 plus 3, 73. So we will get 73 as the output. Next we pass it three parameters, 2, 3, 4. So this 2 will be passed to A, 3 will be passed to B, 4 will be passed to C, and this for this D, this default value will be taken. So 44, 44 plus 3, 47, 47 plus 2, 49. Next 1 comma, 2 comma, 3 comma, 4. So these four values will be passed now. So 1, 2, 3, 4. So 4 plus 3, 7, 7 plus 3, 10. We will get the output like this. So here, what is the beauty of the default arguments? Actually, the function definition contains four arguments, but we can call the function with less number of arguments with the help of default argument concept. So how we can assign the default values? We need to assign default values only from right to left. Sum of A is equal to 10 comma B. This is not a valid statement. Def sum of A is equal to B comma A is equal to 10 comma B. This is not a valid statement. Why? Because we have to assign the default values from right to left, but for the right argument there is no value here. So we can say that this is invalid statement. So if you take this one, a is equal to 1 comma, b is equal to 2 comma, c is equal to 3. So this is the correct statement only. Why? Because from right to left every variable is having some value. Next, let a is not having any value, so there is no problem here. We performed the default value initialization from right to left only. Let a is equal to 1 comma, b is equal to 2 comma c. Is it correct way of initializing default arguments? No, this is wrong one. Why? Because for the rightmost variable, for the rightmost argument, there is no default value here. So this is about default arguments. So if you call the function with less number of arguments, then the corresponding default values will be taken. Let us assume that I called a function like this, sum of. So then what will be the output now? Sum of. Here for the first variable, for the first argument, there is no default value here. So the compiler will display error message. We must provide one value here, okay? Why? Because for the first variable, there is no default value. If we performed some default value initialization here also, then there is no problem. So sum of means we have zero arguments. So all these default values will be considered now and we will get the sum. So this is about the third approach, that is default arguments. Now let's see the last one, that is variable length arguments or arbitrary arguments. The name itself specifies the meaning. Variable length means we can have any number of arguments. We can have any number of arguments. If you don't know how many arguments we need to use in the program, then we can go for the variable length arguments. Variable length argument means in the function call we can specify 0 argument or 1 argument or 2 or 10 or 20 or 30 or 40. We can do like that, okay? Let's take an example for that. So def display of, def display of star n. So here for implementing this concept, we have to use asterisk symbol before n. Before the name of the variable, we have to use the asterisk symbol, okay? Next, this is nothing but function call. I'm sorry, function definition ends with colon symbol. Next to display n value, so print of n. Next to call the function display with 0 arguments. Second function call, display of 1 argument. Third function call, display of 10 comma 2 20. Next to function call, 10 comma 20 comma 30. So likewise, we can pass any number of arguments in the function. Now let's see what will happen here. Display of, here this function call doesn't contain any arguments. So nothing will be stored in n here. Here this n will act as a tuple. We know what is a tuple. Tuple means a collection of elements which are placed in parenthesis symbol. So print of n means what will happen? Here the display function doesn't contain any value. So an empty tuple will be printed like this. Okay. Next one, display of 10. Now what will happen is the tuple n contains only one value, that is 10. This tuple, this n contains only one value, that is 10. So print of n means what will happen? We know if it contains only one element, then after that element a comma symbol will get printed. Otherwise it will be considered as a normal variable. Okay. Next here we pass us two parameters, 10 comma 20. Now n contains these two values, 10 and 20. So if you print the tuple, then 10 and 20 both will be printed. Next here we pass it three parameters, 10, 20, 30. So 10, 20, 30 will be stored in n. Now if you print a n, if you print n, then 10 comma 20 comma 30 will get printed. Or if you want, we can perform some operations. Let us assume that here we are performing some addition operations. Some addition operation, s is equal to 0. So we know how to perform addition operation by using iterator, for loop. So for I in, what is the name of the tuple? N. So for I in n, next let us calculate now. S is equal to s plus I. So now what will happen? Let us assume that this is the function call now. So 10, 20 are stored in n now. So s is equal to 0. Next 4 I in n, what is the first element? 10. So 10 will be stored in I. So now I value is 10. S is equal to s plus I. Previous value of s 0, I value 10. So now sum contains 10. Next element of the tuple is 20. So 20 will be stored in I. So now 20 will be added to s. Then display s here, okay? Then display some value here, okay? So print of s. So that we will get the sum here, okay? So for the first function call, we don't get any sum. For the second function call, 10. For this function call, 30. For this function call, 60. So likewise, we will get the sum. So if we don't know how many number of arguments we need to pass, okay, then we can use as what? This arbitrary arguments or variable length. Variable length means the number of arguments will vary. It is our choice, okay? This is about types of function arguments in Python programming.